Ladies and gentlemen, fellow YouTubers, this is Bharat Nagpal for iGAN.in, and in front of me I have the Micromax Pike. This is also known as the Micromax X510. This is a new touchscreen phone from Micromax, which has various color panels just like the Samsung Corby, but it is in the price range of about 5,000 rupees. So we've just got this phone from Novelty Communications, who are Micromax distributors in New Delhi, and let's do a quick unboxing. In the box, first and foremost, is the Micromax Pike. We'll have a look at that soon. This is very nice foam packaging. This is highly surprising for a phone of this value. You also get covers for your Pike in yellow, orange, white. We like the white a lot. And pink for the ladies or the metrosexual man of today. There is also an orange colored pouch, which is black on one side and orange on the other for your Pike. We also have the USB charger, which is USB output and AC mains charger. That means we only have one data cable in this. You also get a 3.5 millimeter hands-free with an inline microphone and a clip. There's a 3.5 millimeter hands-free jack, and these are in-ear type of earphones, so which is really cool. And this is something unique I have seen from a cheap phone. The headphones look fairly decent. We'll have to check the sound quality and give you a review on that later. Also in the box is the PC Sync CD, the Pike user manual or user guide. There's also a Pike service guide, a warranty card, the battery. This battery is for the Micromax X510. It is a 3.7 volt 1500 milliamp hour battery, which is also a 5.55 watt hour. It's a rechargeable lithium ion battery, just like many other phones of today. Also in the box is your USB to micro USB. Let me just check this. Yes, it is USB to micro USB cable for charging and syncing. Putting all these things aside, let's look at the phone. Let's put the battery inside the phone and also a SIM card so that we can turn this on for you guys. This also has a Samsung style opener for the back case. So I probably forgot to mention, this is also a dual SIM phone. So you can put two SIM cards in here. So I'm just gonna put one right now, which is going to be the IDEA SIM card of iGAN Testing Labs. And let's put in the battery, and I would like to put on the white cover, which is right here, so that we see how this looks. That's a nice fit, looks really nice. So let's power on the device. I think this button should do it. So while this powers on, I'll give you a quick look of the... On the front of the phone, we have the send and end keys. The touchscreen, which looks like a 2.5 inch screen. I'll have the proper specifications at the bottom. On the right side of the phone, there is a camera shutter button, which is a very small camera shutter button, but it is there. On top of the phone, there is a 3.5 millimeter hands-free jack, and also your mini micro USB jack, which is for charging and syncing. On the left-hand side of the phone, there is a there are media keys, which will also act as volume keys, play stop, up down, or volume up down. On the bottom of the phone is your microphone and this little lever or this little hole to pull out the cover. On the back of the phone, we have a 2-megapixel fixed focus camera, and we'll see how that looks in just a bit. So let's turn on the phone, and it does have a slide to unlock, like an iPhone, for example, the UI almost looks like the Samsung Star 3G or something like that. The slide to unlock comes back and it goes back. So on the left-hand side, you have widgets or quick access. You have the music mode in which you can swipe left or right. The touchscreen is a resistive touchscreen, but we must say that it is, we don't need to use our nails. It is working really nicely. And let's bring on the full menu. You can bring on the full menu in Android style. The menu is right here, multimedia, phone book, call logs. Go into connectivity and see that we have data account. There's Bluetooth. We can go back. Let's look at the camera. The camera is a fixed focus camera. I'm not too sure of the megapixels. I believe it's a 2-megapixel camera, but I'll have the specifications at the bottom for you guys. The camera seems okay. It's barely good. I can say the screen is probably not that good to check out the quality of the camera, but either way, it makes a loud noise and almost clicks the photo instantly, so which is a good thing. Coming back to the home screen, this is the dialer. The dialer has big, nice keys, and the screen responds almost as soon as you tap on it, so which is a very, very good thing. It's not like the earlier Micromax phones that I have seen where you tap and the screen is not responsive. So this screen is really nice and responsive. You can dial the number. And this is, I believe, the IDEA helpline. And
unknown amount, dial *147# or log in to our website.
This is the speaker at the back.
www.ideaseminar.com.
So let's hang up the call.
And
yeah, so that's the call. What else can we have a look at? We probably don't have any data, so I can't show you the browser, but we'll just open it anyway. If we can find it. The screen moves left to right, but I can't do anything with it. There's a pond, just like... this is like the Koshi pond, like the iPhone, where you tap, the fish follow. So if you tap here, the fish will follow you, which is a cool interactive thing, but the resolution is so crappy that it looks really bad. So the screen, although looks really nice for a phone of this value, we like the exchangeable covers a lot. Okay, so after a bit of playing around, I did figure out that this does have 3 home screens, which are almost impossible to swipe to, but you have to like really use pressure to go to these different screens. You can insert the second SIM, and you can basically move around these widgets just like the Samsung UI. You can hold on it and the phone vibrates, and then you can just pull it to the side. This button, by the way, is to lock the screen. So that's about it. All in all, it looks like a very decent phone. I'm going to show you the messaging. The keyboard for messaging. We'll select SMS and press OK. And there are some messages, they're probably from the SIM card. So let's click on write a message, and it shows you a numeric keypad. If I want the full QWERTY keypad, I don't know how to get it. Let me just see. If I want to write a message, okay. So this is the message that comes up, but I can probably change the keyboard, I think. No. I don't see any option to change the keyboard, but if we do turn the phone, there is no accelerometer, so it does not change the direction of the phone. So I guess you'll have to message like this. Oh crap. Is A. Test. Okay, so the keyboard is not so bad, but I'm not used to this layout of the keyboard, so it's really difficult for me to type. But I'm sure you can change this somehow. I don't see that option in here. Screen responds nicely, the camera is decent, the processor seems to be all right for this phone. You can change home screens, you can move things around on the screen, your widgets. And if you want the clock here, you can just move it to that place. It is a resistive screen, so you can't use your thumb, but if you use your nails, it'll be much better. You can move things around with your nails, and the screen responds much nicely if you use your nail. Let's lock the phone. Boom. So it locks like that, and this is what it looks like when it's locked. It does have some indications on the top for network, and that the screen is locked and other stuff. There is a clock here, and how much battery is left here. So there you go, guys. This is the Micromax Pike. It comes with exchangeable covers. It also comes with multi-instant messenger Nimbus. It is also social networking ready. It has Snap2 in it, Facebook. It has Opera browser, and it has a 2.8 inch full touch lens and a 2-megapixel fixed focus camera. Those are the basic features. You can get it in Delhi from Novelty Communications, who are distributors for the Micromax phones. Their contact details are at the bottom here, or you can log on to iGAN.in for their contact details. For a full review of this phone, please head over to iGAN.in. Please be sure to rate, subscribe, or comment at the bottom. And stay tuned for more reviews. This has been Bharat Nagpal for iGAN.in, and thank you for watching.